Active Energy says 2015 was a transformational period as the group released financial results for the past year. And joining us now on the phone is Richard Spinks, Chief Executive. Hello, Richard.
Hi, Charlotte.
So, Richard, 2015 was a year of transformation for the company. Can you sum up the key achievements you've made last year?
Well, first of all, we've restructured the business into three distinct divisions with their own management and their own and responsibility for their own destiny, rather than managing them all centrally and trying to identify how they work together synergistically. But now that's all clear, we took the opportunity to basically split them into their own domains, and they're now working much more efficiently. The other things that we've done is that we you know, whilst we suffered some delays, you know, we've significantly increased the volumes that we've been producing in our fiber business, as you'll see in the announcement, by over 40%. And in addition, we've increased enhanced the margins in that division. So we're quite excited about that. We're also now the only supplier in the region, or regional supplier, to our customer base. And that's something that happened in terms of relationship improvement with our customers. So that's very exciting too. In Canada, we seem to have got past all of the issues that we had due to the previous structure and the investigation, or what became subsequently a review by the former government, with the new government being far more indigenous people friendly and supportive of what we're trying to achieve in Alberta, being in line with their own goals and stated goals at their election. And we've had meetings with ministries now, which we in the past was never possible. So we're very excited that that's coming to fruition. And then on the CoalSwitch side, of course, we had our Utah test results through, and that allowed us to supply global players and major industry players with evidence that they could rely on our technology as a reliable option or alternative to burning coal. And as we say in the announcement, you know, we've shortlisted now and are working closely with a number of significant parties who currently burn large amounts of coal in different parts of the world. And at the moment, clearly, we're focusing on tying together all of our expertise from across the three divisions using our key team members. And we're focusing right now on Alberta. So we'll have forestry management, we'll have forestry logistics and wood processing, and we'll also have a coal switch element. And all of that we're looking forward to making an announcement about in the near future.
So, Richard, in terms of your long-term growth plans, is it all about focusing on existing operations and the different divisions you have created, or would you consider developing in new areas as well?
No, I think we've done all of the developing into new areas that we need to do. We're now consolidating ourselves in each of those positions, as we've demonstrated we're able to do with our fibre business, and we'll continue to do that, and we'll continue to cut costs there and to increase margins and to increase volumes and diversify within the sector into the softwood area now, for example. And the same process is now going on in the other two divisions. And there'll be some exciting news coming from both of them, I'm sure, in the coming months as that process moves towards completion. But we're now very much, we know what we are as a company now. We understand which areas of the business we're going to be, of the forestry and forestry management and production businesses we're going to be focused on. And it's now all about building those businesses from where they are today into ever more successful divisions of the group. There's no anticipated diversification further than where we are today, and the synergies are just great. So we're in the right place.
And what difference could all the changes you've made last year make to the bottom line? Because last year you reported an operating loss and a net loss as well of $5.7 million. So what can we expect this year and in the years ahead, potentially? I understand you can't make projections, but if you could just give us an idea.
Well, let's be clear. The way a lot of this is down, and it needs to be read through carefully, a lot of this is down to the way that that companies need are required to report. So, it depends, I suppose, on your view. If your view is that Active Energy Group PLC has now moved from being a one-tune company working in a business that, for example, could take us to 1 million tons a year of production out of Ukraine and into Turkey, and you would have been more happy with that as a final position for the business, then you could say, well, these results aren't so great. If you look at these results and say, but having said that, what they've done is they've developed that business into a nicely profitable division, but that division has allowed them to develop into two other highly prospective business areas, then you probably would say, well, they've actually managed to do quite a lot for very little money. So I prefer to see it in the second format. And I think that once we start to announce more successes in the CoalSwitch and in the forestry management area over the coming year or so, people will start saying that they understand why we did what we did last year, and that those numbers actually are far more acceptable than otherwise they might be. So what we've done is, I think, really quite remarkable with very limited resources. Again, we did the same with the wood fiber business. And I think that we'll now achieve that with our other two divisions. And once that happens, you know, we'll start seeing those two new divisions repaying their debt, if you like, to the core business, and the profits flowing through from the wood fiber business will be visible at the bottom line. And also those other two businesses we would expect and hope will become profitable also over time.
Okay, Richard, thank you very much for the update.
Thank you.
Richard Spinks, Chief Executive at Active Energy.